Oh hi. Welcome to Elmo's world. Elmo didn't see you come in, but that's okay. Because Elmo is so happy to see you. And so is Dorothy. Say hi, Dorothy. Elmo's just been reading book about all the animals in the world. Oh, and guess what Elmo's thinking about today? Today, Elmo is thinking about wild animals.
Wild animals? Now that's a good thing to think about.
Yeah. There are so many different kinds of animals in the world. Like elephants, monkeys, bears, lions, tigers, jaguars, raccoons, all kinds of wild animals. What do you like about animals? Really? Wow, that's a great thing to like about animals.
Yeah. And you know, most people tend to pick an animal to be their favorite.
Yeah, that's true. Oh, and hey, I have a favorite wild animal too.
Really? What's your favorite wild animal, Spot?
Play Spot's Clues to figure it out.
Great thinking. We'll play Spot's Clues to figure out what Spot's favorite wild animal is. We are gonna play Spot's Clues, cause it's a really great game, yeah. So remember, Spot's paw prints will be on the clues. Spot's Clues. You know what we need for Spot's Clues. Our handy dandy.
Notebook.
Notebook, right.
Come on. Let's open the drawer and see what's inside. Oh, here it is. You know, Elmo and his friends are really gonna need your help today, trying to figure out what Spot's favorite wild animal is. Will you help? You will? Great.
To play Spot's Clues, we gotta find three.
Paw prints. 1, 2, 3. And that's one of our clues.
Our clues?
A clue.
And then we put it in our notebook. Because they're Spot's Clues. Spot's Clues. You know what to do.
Think.
Cause when we use our minds, take a step at a time, we can do anything.
Whiff,
that we wanna do.
Are you ready? It's time to play Spot's Clues to figure out what Spot's favorite wild animal is. Will you help? You will? Great.
Ooh, what's that, Dorothy? Oh, okay. Elmo will ask the question.
What did she say, Elmo?
Dorothy wants to know, what kind of animal is a wild animal?
Oh, good question, Dorothy.
Let's ask Mr. Noodle. Mr. Noodle! Hi, Mr. Noodle. No, over here, Mr. Noodle. No, not down there, Mr. Noodle. Boy, those binoculars don't work very well. Too far down, keep going up, 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 up. There, stop. Oh, Mr. Noodle, no wonder you can't see through the binoculars. You still have the cover on. Take the covers off. Yay! Hi, Mr. Noodle. Hi. Oh, now, can Mr. Noodle stop playing with the binoculars, please? Dorothy has a question. You ready? Good. What kind of animal is a wild animal? There he goes. Oh.
What animal is that? Is it a dog? I think he's a frog.
He's watching his face like a kitty.
Mr. Noodle's pretending to be a cat.
Yeah, a cat.
Wow, that's a big ball of yarn.
Cats love to play with yarn.
But a cat is not a wild animal, Mr. Noodle.
A cat's a pet. Cats live with people. What's a wild animal, Mr. Noodle?
He's mooing like a cow.
Cows live on farms. They're not wild.
Farmers take care of them. They live around people, too.
Try again, Mr. Noodle.
Try again.
Is that a dog?
I don't think so.
Oh, a seal!
Yay! Good job, Mr. Noodle!
A seal is a wild animal.
They live in the sea!
Oh, it's Wolfgang! Wolfgang is a seal, too!
Good seal, Mr. Noodle! Boy, that Mr. Noodle is some silly seal!
I'll say. These noodles get more sillier every time. Even when they're pretending to be something. Well, come on, we better go start looking for clues.
A clue, a clue!
Huh? Is there a wild animal in here?
No, a clue!
Oh, you see a clue.
On Blue's tail. Looks like a tail is our first clue to what Spot's favorite wild animal is. Who wants to draw this clue first?
Me. I'll draw this clue. Let's draw a long, curvy, skinny tail, like this. There, a tail.
Alright, so what could Spot's favorite animal be, with a tail?
Oh, good thinking. But maybe we should find two more clues, just to be sure.
Well, in the meantime, Elmo has a question. For you guys, and you.
Oh boy. What's today's question, Elmo?
Elmo wants to know, how many spots are on a leopard? Let's count them and see.
Alright. Count with us.
Hi, leopard.
One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight, nine, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14.
Ah, wow! And one more spot. 15, that's 15 spots. Hi, leopard. Great counting, everybody.
15 spots. Wow, that's a whole lot of spots.
Yeah, 15 spots. I didn't know leopards had that many spots. Good to know.
And now that the questions are done, it's time for today's drawer game, about wild animals.
Oh boy. What do we need to do in this wild animals drawer game spot?
Very simple. All you have to do is figure out where do wild animals live.
Oh okay. Let's see what we have.
Wah. Whoa. Got you this time, Elmo. Phew. Thanks.
Where do gorillas live? In a bathtub? In the jungle? Or on a tricycle?
In the jungle!
Very good! Gorillas live in the jungle! Where do deer live? On the moon? In a boat? Or in the woods?
Deer live in the woods!
That's right! Deer don't live on the moon or in a boat! Deer live in the woods! Very good! Where do elephants live? In a teacup? A trash can? Or grasslands?
Elephants live in grasslands.
That's right. Elephants don't live in trash cans. Unless it's Oscar's elephant Fluffy.
Time for your mud bath, Fluffy.
Great job figuring out where animals live. But it is kind of strange that Oscar has a pet elephant.
Oh well. What do you expect from Oscar? Anyway, thanks for playing today's drawer game. Until next time.
Who would have thought that Oscar actually has a wild animal as a pet? Makes me wonder what else he has in that trash can of his.
Elmo and friends will figure that out later. For now, let's keep on looking for clues.
Yeah, come on.
Did you see a clue? Where? Oh, look at that. The paw print is hopping. I guess hopping is our second clue. We need our handy dandy.
Notebook.
Notebook, right. For hopping, let's make a line that goes up and down, like this. There, hopping.
Okay, Elmo's turn. So Elmo will draw a line that goes up and down, for hopping. There, hopping.
Okay. So our first clue, is a tail.
And And now our second clue is hopping. A tail and hopping. Which animal is Spot's favorite with these clues?
Oh, good thinking. But let's find our last clue to figure this out.
Elmo has mail!
Hey, Elmo and his friends just got an email.
Oh look, it's an email from our friends.
Hi guys. I'm Jungle Jack, and we're gonna meet some animals today. This is a bobcat. They call it a bobcat because it has a bob tail. Now look at this one. This is a palm civet. Let's feed it a piece of banana. This is a tortoise. This is a land animal. And look at the armadillo. Look at its shell. He rolls up into a ball to protect himself. Oh my gosh, what is this? This is a toad. They hop all the time. Now look at this one. Everyone has seen one of these. It's a penguin. They have more feathers than any bird in the world. Bye guys.
Bye.
Thanks, computer.
Those were some great animals we saw.
They sure were. Elmo liked those animals. But now, Elmo wants to learn more about wild animals.
Ooh, and we know what to do about that. We can watch a channel to learn more.
Yeah, we can watch the Wild Animals Channel, TV.
The Wild Animal Channel, where the wild things are.
And now it's time for Wild Wild Kingdom with Marla Perkins.
Hi, I'm Marla Perkins. I visit wild animals all over the world. And today we're going to visit some wild animals called marsupials who live in the wild, wild kingdom of Australia. Isn't that wild? Let's go down under and out back to say good day to them. First stop, we're going to say good day to a koala bear. Isn't he adorable? Good day, koala bear. Koalas spend their day eating eucalyptus leaves. And sleeping. Wild. And here's another marsupial. The one that hops. A kangaroo. Good day, kangaroo. Kangaroos don't need nests because they have pouches for their babies. Good day, baby kangaroo. That's what I call a mobile home. And here's another marsupial, a wombat. They have pouches, too, and they waddle. Good day, wombat. Kangaroos hop and wombats waddle. And koalas snore. Sounds like a dance. The marsupial waddle, hop, and snore. Waddle, waddle, hop, hop. Waddle, waddle, hop, hop. That's a marsupial waddle hoppin'. Wild! I'm Marla Perkins saying good day from the wild, wild kingdom of Australia. Waddle, waddle, hop, hop. Waddle, waddle, hop, hop.
Coming up next on the Wild Animal Channel, The Lion in Winter, starring Lionel Barrymore, followed by The Lion King with Tiger Woods.
Now those were some great animals.
They sure were. Thanks, TV.
Huh? Are there wild animals in here?
I think it's coming from over there.
Oh look, it's a picture of a jungle. And Spot just Skidoo there. Come on, Spot Skidoo. We can too.
Wow, Elmo's never been to a jungle before.
Me neither. There are lots of wild animals here in the jungle. Come on, let's go find them.
Oh, hello Lion Prince.
Hello, friends. You have to help me. I think three of the animals are hiding, even though they know it's time for their nap.
How can Elmo and friends help?
If we make the same noise as the animals, they'll come out.
Will you help us with this? Great. Yes, sir, Mr. Lion Prince. We can help you find the animals.
All right. Look into the jungle and listen for their sounds. Can you make the same noise as the animal?
Ooh, Ooh, I think it's working. Louder, can you make the sounds louder?
Ribbit! Ribbit!
Do you see him?
Ribbit.
Which one of the animals is it?
The frog!
Oh, the frog.
Frog, we found you. Outstanding. But we have two more animals to find.
Bark, bark.
Oh, I think Blue hears another animal. Come on.
Do you hear that? Can you make the same noise as her?
Wow, you are so good at making animal noises. Do you see her?
Can you see which animal it is?
An elephant.
An elephant?
Yes.
Oh, it is an elephant.
Elephant, we found you. Magnificent. We still have one more animal to find.
All right. Let's find our last animal.
Can you make the noise of the animal?
Hey, that's great. I think it's working. Keep it up.
Do you see him? Which one of the animals is it?
A monkey!
A monkey? Where is the monkey?
Right there!
Oh, it is a monkey.
Thanks for helping me find all the animals.
No problem, Lion Prince. Great job!
Come on, do it with us. It's kind of fun.
There goes Spot. Let's go. Sorry. Those monkey noises sort of got the best of me.
Well, now that we found all those animals in the jungle, and got them ready for their nap, we still need to figure out what Spot's favorite wild animal is.
Yeah. Elmo and friends still need one more clue.
A clue, a clue!
A clue? You see our last clue?
Where?
Oh, on this pocket. Our last clue is a pocket.
All right, we need our handy dandy.
Notebook.
Notebook, right. So, a pocket. Let's start with an oval on the top. A line that goes down and around, and some small little lines all around the pocket. There, a pocket.
All right, my turn. So we draw an oval on the top, a curved line that goes down and around, and some small lines all around the pocket. There, a pocket.
Hey, we have all three clues to figure out what Spot's favorite wild animal is.
All three clues. You know what that means. We're ready to sit in our
thinking chair.
Thinking chair, right. Come on.
Now that we're in our thinking chair, let's think.
Okay. So we're trying to figure out what Spot's favorite wild animal is. And our clues are, a tail.
Hopping.
And a pocket.
So what do you think Spot's favorite wild animal is, with a tail, hopping, and a pocket?
Well, lots of animals have tails. Like lions, tigers, elephants, and monkeys.
Yeah, and some animals hop too. Like frogs, lemurs, and monkeys too. But, none of them have pockets.
Yeah, what about this pocket?
Well, maybe there's an animal that has a pocket built into them. So, if Spot's favorite animal has a tail,
and hops around, and has a built-in pocket into it, then what kind of animal is that?
A kangaroo.
A kangaroo. Yeah, that's it. Spot's favorite wild animal is a kangaroo.
Oh yeah. Because kangaroos have long tails, they like to hop around, and they have pockets built into them to carry their babies in. We just figured out Spot's clues.
We just figured out Spot's clues.
We just figured out Spot's clues.
We just figured out Spot's clues. Because we're really smart. Wow, Spot, I didn't know you liked kangaroos.
Sure do. Kangaroos are my favorite wild animals. Well, what does Spot like about kangaroos? I'll show you. So, here's what I like about kangaroos. They live in Australia. And they're also marsupials from the family Macropodidae. And I also like that they carry their babies in their pockets, which are called pouches. It's a really nice way to carry their babies around.
It's true. It really is. Plus, it's also cute that they can carry their babies in their pouches. Hey, what about you? What do you like about kangaroos?
Really? Well, that's a nice thing to like about kangaroos. Oh, hey Mars, we never asked you. What's your favorite wild animal?
Oh, that's easy. A panda bear. I like how adorable they are.
Oh yeah. Pandas are adorable.
Oh look. Dorothy is imagining Elmo as a panda.
Dorothy is imagining my favorite animal? Cool.
Yeah! Elmo panda!
Some wild animals eat insects, like the aardvark. They have long snouts for sniffing out bugs.
Elmo's an aardvark, and he's proud. Elmo's an aardvark, and he's happy. Oh, no. There goes Elmo Aardvark's lunch.
Wow, this has been one crazy wild day. And we loved it. Thanks for spending this wild day with us.
Yeah, Elmo loves wild animals. And so does Dorothy. That's why Dorothy wants us to sing the wild animals song.
May we sing along too?
Be our guests. Let's sing.
Get ready! Animals, animals, wild animals. Everybody!
Wild, wild animals, wild animals. Animals, animals, wild animals. Wild, wild animals, wild animals.
Say goodbye, Dorothy. Say goodbye.
It must be fun having a fish for a pet like Dorothy.
It sure is. Oh hi. Welcome to Elmo's world. Noah and Elmo are so happy you're here. And so is Dorothy. Say hi, Dorothy.
Elmo and I were just watching Dorothy swimming around in her bowl. She really looks like she's having fun in there. In fact, I think a lot of fishes love swimming around.
Yeah, they sure do. Ooh, that reminds Elmo. Elmo is thinking about fishes today. And Dorothy is a fish, and she likes to swim around.
Yeah, that's true. Fishes are great sea creatures, because they come in all kinds of shapes and colors. There are different kinds of fishes in the world. Like goldfishes, clownfish, tuna, even sharks are fishes. Hey, what kinds of fish do you like? Ooh, that sounds like a good kind of fish you like.
We heard fish. Are we learning about fish today?
We sure are. Elmo was just telling us he was learning about fish today.
And Elmo's favorite fish is Dorothy. Aw, that's a nice thing to say to Dorothy, Elmo. And hey, If Dorothy is Elmo's favorite fish, do you want to know what my favorite kind of fish is? Of course we do, Spot. What's your favorite kind of fish? Play Spot's Clues to figure it out.
Great idea. We'll play Spot's Clues to figure out what Spot's favorite kind of fish is. We are gonna play Spot's Clues, cause it's a really great game. Yeah. So remember, Spot's paw prints will be on the clues. Spot's Clues. You know what we need for Spot's Clues? Our handy dandy.
Notebook!
Notebook, right.
Come on. Let's open the drawer and see what's inside. Oh, here it is. You know, Elmo and his friends are really gonna need your help today, trying to figure out what Spot's favorite kind of fish is. Will you help? You will? Great.
To play Spot's Clues, we gotta find three.
Pumpkins. 1, 2, 3. If that's one of our
clues. Our clues?
And then we put it in our notebook. Because they're Spot's Clues. Spot's Clues. You know what to do.
Sit down in our
Think.
Think.
Because when we use our minds, take a step at a time, we can do anything.
Woof, woof.
That we want to do.
Ready to play Spot's Clues to figure out what Spot's favorite kind of fish is? You are? Great.
Ooh. What's that, Dorothy? Oh, okay. Elmo will ask the question.
What did she say, Elmo?
Dorothy wants to know, how do you pretend to be a fish?
Oh, good question, Dorothy.
Let's ask Mr. Noodle! Mr. Noodle! Oh, wow! Well, that really looks like water shade. Thank you! Hi, Mr. Noodle! Hi! Over here, Mr. Noodle! No! Here, Mr. Noodle! Oh, boy. Your hat is over your eyes, Mr. Noodle. Your hat, yeah.
That's better. Hi there, Mr. Noodle.
Doggy asks, how do you pretend to be a fish, Mr. Noodle? Yeah, you, Mr. Noodle. You.
That's not a fish.
He's pretending to be a dog.
No! Fish can't scratch their ears!
He's rolling around like a dog.
I think he's scratching his back.
Swim, Mr. Noodle.
Fish don't beg. Fishes swim.
Fish don't eat bones.
Bones are for dogs, not fish.
Let's see your fish, Mr. Noodle.
Fishes have fins, so they can swim.
You need to swim to be a fish.
You're doing it wrong.
Not like that.
You're not being a fish.
That's a chicken, Mr. Noodle. He's being a chicken.
Chickens can't swim.
Not even the breaststroke.
Fish don't cluck.
Their mouths say...
Glub, 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 glub.
Be a fish, Mr. Noodle.
Yay, Mr. Noodle!
Mr. Noodle, you're doing it. That's a fish.
Almost as good as Dorothy.
He looks like a real fish. All he needs is some water.
Mr. Noodle. Thank you, Shade.
That Mr. Noodle. You never know what he's gonna do next.
Yeah, he's really silly every time. Even when he's being a fish. Well, come along, fishies. We've got some clues to find.
A clue, a clue!
You see a clue? Where?
Oh, our first clue is a fish. How convenient. You know what we need, our handy dandy.
Notebook!
Notebook. So, a fish. We have an oval for the body, some squiggly lines for the scales, a circle here for an eye, and some
So, what could Spot's favorite kind of fish be with the fish?
Maybe. But I think we need to find two more clues to figure this out.
Hey, Elmo.
Oh, hi, Cupcake. You're just in time for Elmo's question. Elmo wants to know, how many fish do we see? Let's count them and see.
All right. Count with us.
One fish.
Two fish.
Three fish.
Four fishes. There were four fishes.
Wow. Where are all the little fishes hurrying to?
The Soul Train. Interesting. Thanks, little fishes.
Ha ha. That was so funny.
Sure is. But, Elmo wonders, where else do fishes live? Over here, guys. We can figure out by these three choices in the drawer. Drawer, if you please.
Can fishes live in a bus? In a birthday cake? Or a river?
In a river.
Fishes live in water.
Very good, that's right. Can fishes live in a stroller? In a car? Or in a lake?
A lake.
It's water.
That's right. Now, where does Dorothy live? Does she live in an ocean? In a raindrop? Or in a fishbowl?
In a fishbowl.
Yes, with Elmo. Oh, and Elmo loves Dorothy.
It's true the fishes live in the pond or the lake. And of course Dorothy lives in her bowl with Elmo. We all know how much he loves her.
Yeah, that's true. Thanks for that, Spot. Wow. It's really amazing to find lots of fishes anywhere in the world. Such as the pond and lake, and Dorothy in her bowl. Don't you think? Well, we better keep on looking for clues.
Can I come with you guys?
Sure, Cupcake. Grab your notebook.
Here it is.
Great. Then come on, let's go look for more clues.
A clue, a clue!
Yeah, there really are a lot of fishes in the world.
No, a clue!
Oh, you see our next clue? Where?
Right there!
Oh, there is a clue. On the letter D. You know what we need, our handy dandy.
Notebook!
Notebook, right. I'm drawing this clue too.
Great, we'll draw this clue together. So, the letter D. Let's draw a line that goes down and around like this for the letter D.
All right, my turn. So we start with a line that goes down and around like this to make the letter D.
Okay, so we need to figure out what Spot's favorite kind of fish is. And our first clue is a fish.
And now our second clue is the letter D. A fish and the letter D. What kind of fish is Spot's favorite with these things?
Really? You think so? Well, maybe Elmo and friends should find one more Spot's clue to figure this out.
Elmo has mail!
Hey, Elmo and his friends just got an email.
Oh look, it's an email from Click and Terrence.
Hey guys, Click and are at the aquarium. There's tons have different fishes here.
Like this fish over here. The blue tang.
And this one right here. The butterfly fish. These are some pretty fishes. Bye, guys.
Bye.
Thanks, computer.
Oh, yeah. I totally forgot you could find fishes at the aquarium. Spot and I took a field trip there.
Wow. An aquarium with lots of fishes. That does sound great, but Elmo wants to learn more about fishes.
So do we. And when we want to learn more about something, what do we do?
Watch a channel.
Yeah, watch a channel. We can watch the Fish Channel.
It's the Fish Channel. All fishes, all newts, all the time. And now, Finn fans, here's Bubbles Martin in the swim with How Do Fishes Move?
Bubbles Martin underwater asking, how do fishes move? A few of them look like they're flying. Hi, Ray. Most fishes move by wiggling their body, tail, and fins. The works. Wiggle, wiggle, wiggle. wiggle. You want to get anywhere as a fish, you gotta wiggle.
Here's a thing that fishes know when they got someplace to go. Just to swim there fast or slow, they gotta wiggle, 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 wiggle. They got tails, they got fins, they got scales on their skins. But when travel time begins, they gotta wiggle, 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 wiggle. Godfish with their puppies know, and guppies who are on the go. To start swimming, hey, diddle, diddle, flip your tail and bend in the middle. Ladies and clams, the fishettes! Wiggle, 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 wiggle! You can wiggle too! Try it! Wiggle with Bubbles! Here's a thing that fishes know, when they got some place to go. Just to swim there fast or slow, they gotta wiggle, 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 wiggle. See you at Laguna Beach, and that's how fishes move.
Stay tuned for Name That Tuna, 60 minnows and touched by an angel fish.
Now that was a good way to learn how fishes move.
It sure was. Thanks, TV. Hey, you guys.
Hey, Spot. What's that you're playing?
It's a fish expedition game. You find all these interesting little fishes in this game. Come on, let's go see them. La 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 la.
Let's go. Spot Skydoo. We can too.
Wow. I've never seen a game like this before.
Neither has Elmo.
Bark, bark.
You have?
Bark. Hi. I'm Lady Good Diver. I'm getting ready to go on an expedition to find some fish. Wanna come?
Us? In a submarine? Of course we would. Do you wanna go into a submarine to learn about fish? You do. Great. Come on.
Oh boy. We're going underwater.
Look. There's a seahorse. And a porcupine fish.
Wow. Elmo's never seen these kinds of sea creatures before.
Me either. This is so cool.
Okay. Now here's where I need your help. We need to find these camouflage fish.
Camouflage? What's camouflage?
Camouflage is what animals look like what's around them, so they can hide.
Oh, that's right. We learned that before. So, we'll help look the camouflage fish, right? Great.
Okay. So first, we need to find this leaf fish, and I think it's hiding somewhere around here.
I don't see it. Maybe you can help. So, the leaf fish looks brown and scaly. Do you see where it's hiding?
Over there, the leaves!
Wow. Look at that. The leaf fish can hide in the leaves, because the leaves is the same color as the fish.
Huh? Why is this hiding?
Oh, I think the leaf fish is hiding to protect itself from that big fish.
Wow, that sure was a big fish.
It sure was. Good thing for camouflage.
Okay, now I need to find the rockfish. It lives at the very bottom of the ocean.
Okay, let's see. So, this rockfish is kind of grayish.
Right. Let's see if we can find it.
All right. Do you see the rockfish anywhere?
Over there! In the rocks!
Wow. Look at that. The rockfish looks just like the rocks, so you can barely see it.
It's hiding again. Why do you think the rockfish is hiding?
Did you see that? I think the rockfish was hiding, so it could catch the little fish and eat it.
Oh, I guess sometimes big fish catch a little fish and eat them for food.
Wow, Elmo didn't know about that.
I think the parrotfish lives around here.
Parrotfish? Ooh, very colorful. Okay, let's see if we can find it. Do you see the parrotfish anywhere?
Right there!
Wow, that's amazing.
Yeah, the parrotfish is hiding in that bubble. That's got to be the most incredible thing I have seen.
Why do you think the parrotfish is hiding?
Oh, that's why.
That's right. The parrotfish made that hiding place all by itself, so it can sleep safely.
Wow. Great job. You sure do know where these fishes were hiding.
I found all the fish I need to find. Let's go back up.
Everybody careful.
Thanks for the trip.
Anytime. You guys are great submarine divers.
Wow. That was such a fun trip.
It sure was. Hey, Spot, were any of those fishes we found was your favorite?
Not quite. You still have one more clue to find.
Oh, right. We better skidoo back to Elmo's world and find our last clue. Let's go.
A clue, a clue!
You wanna go on another fish expedition? Well, maybe another time.
No, it's a clue!
Oh, you see a clue. Where is it?
Right there!
Oh, on these colors, orange and gold. We have our third clue.
All right. Elmo and I will draw this clue together. I'll go first. First we'll draw a splotch shape here, and then we color it orange, like this. And then we draw another splotch shape, and color it gold, for this one. There, orange and gold. Okay. Elmo's turn. So Elmo will draw a splotch shape here, and then we color it orange, like this. And then we draw another splotch shape, and color it gold, for this one. There, orange and gold. Hey! We have all three clues to figure out what Spot's favorite kind of fish is.
All three clues. You know what that means. We're ready to sit in our
thinking chair.
Thinking chair. Let's go.
Now that we're in our thinking chair, let's think.
Okay, so, we need to figure out what Spot's favorite kind of fish is. And our clues are, a fish.
The letter D.
And the colors orange and gold.
So what do you think Spot's favorite kind of fish is, with the fish, the letter D, and the colors orange and gold?
You know, something about these things looks familiar. Like, maybe there's a kind of fish that's orange and gold. And maybe, this fish's name has the letter D in it.
Ooh, that's a good guess. But, what kind of fish is that?
Dorothy.
Dorothy?
Yeah, it's Dorothy. Dorothy is the answer to Spot's clues.
Yeah, because Dorothy is a fish that's orange and gold, and her name starts with the letter D.
Well, I'll be. It is Dorothy. She's the answer to Spot's clues. We just figured out Spot's clues.
We just figured out Spot's clues.
We just figured out Spot's clues. Because we're really smart.
Wow. Looks like you and Spot have the same favorite kind of fish, Elmo.
Elmo thinks so too. Wow, Spot. Elmo didn't know Dorothy was Spot's favorite fish too. Yep. She's my favorite fish too. Sometimes she and I like to talk about stuff while you guys are searching for clues.
Wow. Who would have thought?
That's really great that you and Dorothy get along, Spot. Wow. Have you ever known about that? So, what else should we do now?
I would like to know more about fishies, wouldn't you? How can we find out more? Oh, here we go again, yay! Bloop, bloop, bloop!
Why don't you talk to a fish?
Who said that?
I hope you don't mind.
Oh, look, a toad!
And I brought my own water. Fish live in the water, you know. Even
a kingfish.
Wow, he's a kingfish.
Wow. Yes, wow. Every inch a kingfish. Mm. This is my royal tail. I use it to swim.
His royal tail.
And my royal fins. I use them to swim, too.
His royal fins.
And my royal gills. I use them to breathe.
His royal... what was that again?
My royal gills.
Your royal gills.
Yes, and my royal mouth. I use it to say, forsooth.
His royal forsooth. What else can fish do besides swim and breathe and say, forsooth?
Well, anything almost. They can blow up like a balloon if they're puffers. What is that goldfish doing?
Some fish can fly if they're flying fish. And some fishes can make their own light if they're anglerfish.
Elmo's an anglerfish. That's a switch. Now Elmo Fish can read his book of fish stories.
Wow. This day has been filled with lots of fishes today. Don't you think?
It sure has. We've learned so much about fishes. That they come in all kinds of shapes and colors, they're in all kinds of species, and they can camouflage themselves to hide from ocean predators. Wow, this has been such a great day.
It sure was. Thanks for learning about fish with Elmo and friends. And now, Elmo wants to sing the fish song. This is Elmo's world. Elmo is so happy to see you. And so is Dorothy. Say hi, Dorothy. It's time for another day here in Elmo's world. Because today, Elmo is thinking about the weather. And good thing too. Because it's raining outside. Elmo and his friends saw it outside.
It's true. It's pouring rain outside today. And, you know, rain is a type of weather.
Yeah. There's different kinds of weather to be outside. Like sunny, windy, rainy, stormy, all kinds of weather. Hey, what kind of weather do you like?
Ooh, I like that kind of weather too. And I do like the rain, but sometimes I wish it was sunny outside.
Well, maybe the weather might change into something else. And, I think I know what it might be.
Do you? Well, what kind of weather do you think is coming, Spot?
Play Spot's clues to figure it out.
Oh. We'll play Spot's clues to figure out what weather Spot thinks is coming. We are gonna play Spot's clues, cause it's a really great game, yeah. So remember, Spot's paw prints will be on the clues. Spot's clues. You know what we need for Spot's clues. Our handy dandy.
Notebook!
Notebook, right.
Come on. Let's open the drawer and see what's inside.
Oh, here it is. You know, Elmo and his friends are really gonna need your help today, trying to figure out what weather Spot thinks is coming. Will you help? You will? Great.
To play Spot's clues, we gotta find three.
Pawprints.
Pawprints. One, two, three. And that's one of our
clues.
Our clues?
A clue.
And then we put it in our notebook. Because they're Spot's clues. Spot's clues. You know what to do.
Sit down in our thinking chair. And think.
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 Cause when we use our minds, take a step at a time, we can do anything.
Woof woof.
That we want to do.
Are you ready? It's time to look for Spot's clues to figure out what kind of weather Spot thinks is coming. Will you help? You will? Great.
Ooh. What's that, Dorothy? Oh, okay. Elmo will ask the question. What did she say, Elmo? Dorothy wants to know, what do you wear when it rains?
Oh, that's a good question.
Let's ask Mr. Noodle. Mr. Noodle! Oh, whoa, sounds like thunder. Is it gonna rain? Oh, go up, Shade. Let's see. Come on, Shade. Oh, it's Mr. Noodle. Hi, Mr. Noodle. Hi. Oh, it's thundering. Oh, and now it's starting to rain, Mr. Noodle. Mr. Noodle.
What do you wear when it rains?
Uh-oh. You need a raincoat, Mr. Noodle. No, that's a swimsuit, Mr. Noodle.
That's for swimming.
That's what you wear under the water.
Mr. Noodle, get a raincoat.
You don't wear that when it's raining.
You need a raincoat for the rain.
And a rain hat.
Try again, Mr. Noodle.
Mr. Noodle?
That's a winter coat and a sled.
What do you wear in the rain? To keep dry, Mr. Noodle.
What's he going to do with the sled?
You don't use a sled in the rain.
Sleds are for the snow, not the rain.
Oh, Mr. Noodle, you forgot your sled.
Yay, you did it.
Good job, Mr. Noodle.
You wear a raincoat and boots.
Now open the umbrella.
You're still getting wet. Come on, Mr. Noodle.
You have to open it, Mr. Noodle. Upside down. Mr. Noodle.
Not like that. Hold the handle. Yeah, like that.
Yay, Mr. Noodle.
What's he doing?
Can dance.
Oh, very nice, Mr. Noodle. That Mr. Noodle, he's all wet.
But he sure is pretty funny. And at least he got something right for a change. Don't you think? Well, we better go look for clues now. Let's go.
Huh?
Where'd this cloud come from?
A clue, a clue!
No, it's a cloud.
Oh, this cloud is a clue. We have our first clue.
Oh, I see now. Well, we better put this cloud clue in our handy dandy
notebook.
Notebook, right. To draw a cloud, we draw a big puffy shape like this to make a cloud. There, a cloud. Okay, so what our kind first of weather spot is a thinks cloud. Is coming with a cloud.
Oh, good thinking. But I think we better find two more clues. Just to be sure.
Well, in the meantime, Elmo has a question. For you guys, and you.
Oh boy. What's today's question, Elmo?
Elmo wants to know, how many raindrops are falling from this cloud? Let's count them and see.
Oh boy. Okay, count with us.
One, two, three. 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20, 21, 22, 23, 24, 25, 26, 27, 28, 29, 30, 31, 32, 33, 34, 35, 36, 37, 38, 39, 40, 41, 42, 43, 44, 45, 46, 47, 48, 49, 50, 51, 52, 53, 54, 55, 56, 57, 58, 59, 60, 61, 62, 63, 64, 65, 66, 67, 68, 69, 70, 71, 72, 73, 74, 75, 76, 77, 78, 79, 80, 81, 82, 83, 84, 85, 86, 87, 88, 89, 90, 91, 92, 93, 94, 95, 96, 97, 98, 100, 101, 102, 103, 104, 105, 106, 107, 108, 109, 110, 111, 112, 113, 114, 115, 116, 117, 118, 119, 120, 121, 122, 123, 124, 125, 126, 127, 128, 129, 130, 131, 132,
So, I guess we'll just say that this question is remained unsolved. Oh well, maybe next time.
That's okay. But hey, that really was a nice rainbow.
If you guys think that rainbow was nice from Elmo's question, wait till you see today's drawer game.
Ooh, a new drawer game.
What's today's drawer game spot? Is it about the weather?
More like fixing up a season. But it does have weather in it. Check it out. Phew. That was wah-ah.
Not again.
Hey, I remember this picture. Julia made this. That's right. In this game, you need to help this character fix fall. You know, like how Steve and Blue fix winter.
Oh, okay. Help us out with this. First, let's start with the kind of weather that happens in fall. What kind of weather happens in fall? Sunny, rainy, or windy?
Windy.
Windy, right. Because in the fall, it always gets cold and windy. So, the kind of weather for fall is windy.
That's right. It gets really windy in the fall. Good job.
Okay, so it gets windy in the fall. What else is there to fix in the picture?
Our little friend here. She looks like she could use some better clothes for the fall. Okay. So, what our friend needs is a coat. Which coat should our friend wear to stay warm?
That one.
Oh, the magenta coat. That's sure to help her stay warm.
That's right. She'll be much warmer now. But, something's still not right in her picture.
Oh yeah? Well, what is there to fix in the picture? Do you see anything?
Right there!
Woohoo! Oh yeah! You can't go swimming in the fall. It's just too cold. So, what else can you do in the fall?
That one!
A leaf pile. That's right. Because you can rake leaves, and then play in them.
Yes. That's it. You did it. You fixed the picture. Great job.
Wow. Great job helping us fix the season. That girl is sure to stay nice and warm in the fall.
She sure will. Well, that's it for today's drawer game. Thanks for playing. Until next time.
Bark, 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 bark.
Elmo's okay, Blue. Drawer is always pushing Elmo a lot.
That's okay. We'll get Drawer to cooperate one day. But for now, let's keep on searching for clues.
A clue, a clue!
Yeah, you did great at figuring out what happens in the fall.
A clue right there!
Oh, there is a clue. On this drop. A water drop. Who's gonna draw this clue?
Me. I'll draw this clue. We have a line that curves around, with a point on top. There, a drop of water.
Okay. So our first clue is a cloud.
And now our second clue is a drop of water.
So what kind of weather Spot thinks is coming, with a cloud and a drop of water?
Oh, that's a good possibility. But I think we should find our last clue, just to be sure.
Elmo has mail!
Hey, Elmo and his friends just got an email.
Oh look, it's an email from Anna and Elsa.
Hi guys. We sent you this email to tell you about the snow. As you know, snow is a type of weather.
And there's lots of things you can do in the snow. Like building a snowman, ice skating, making snow angels, snowball fights, building a snow fort, all kind of stuff to do in the snow.
That's why we love the snow. We love all those things. Bye guys.
Bye.
Thanks, computer.
Wow. I guess everybody has a favorite type of weather.
It sure looks like it. So Elmo, do you think you understand what we're learning, or do you still want to learn more about the weather?
Elmo would still like to learn more about the weather.
I do too. I think we all do. And when Elmo wants to learn more about something, what do?
Watch a channel.
Yeah, we can watch the Weather Channel.
The Weather Channel, blowing into your home. And now, the Weather Lady and the Four Seasons.
Hello, I'm the Weather Lady and this is my dog, Sunny Boy.
We both love the weather. All kinds.
Woof, woof, woof.
He's not just a fair weather friend. Ha!
Woof.
We love the seasons too. All four of them.
Woof, 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 woof.
Take summer. The weather outside is hot and sunny. And sometimes it gets too hot in the summer to do anything except swim. Ooh, they don't call them dog days for nothing. After summer, autumn comes. It gets colder and windier. The leaves turn beautiful colors. And then they fall off the trees. Hey, that's what autumn is sometimes called. Fall. Leaf it to Sunny Boy. Ah. Then it gets even colder and winter sets in. Sometimes it snows. Doesn't it, Sunny Boy? Then it starts to get warmer and the snow melts. And it's spring. Not too hot, not too cold. Just a little wet. It rains so flowers and plants can grow. Sometimes it rains so hard, even the weather lady has to go inside. Yes, you too, Sunny Boy. I love the weather. Whether it's summer or fall, winter or spring, and so does Sunny Boy. That's right, dude.
Coming up on the Weather Channel, a snowman for all seasons. Catch it before it melts.
Wow. Now that's someone who really loves the weather.
Yeah. Thanks, TV.
You know, Elmo, one of the best things that happens after it rains is a rainbow. You like rainbows, don't you?
Yes. Elmo loves rainbows. But Elmo doesn't know how a rainbow is made.
Actually, me either. Maybe that's another thing we need to learn. How a rainbow is made.
L-A-L-A-L-A-L-A-L-A.
Hey, it's a picture of the rainbow. And Spot just skydoed into it. Come on. Spot skydoo. We can too.
Wow. What a nice place.
Yeah, come on.
Don't you know I'm a rainbow? Oh, oh.
The name's Rainbow.
Wow, what a beautiful rainbow. Excuse Elmo, but can Rainbow come back to Elmo's world and shine her colors? We want to see how rainbows are made.
No can do, sweet peas. I can't just show up anywhere. I need three things before I appear in the sky.
Oh? Well, what three things do you need to form?
Come on up here and I'll show you.
Oh boy, come on.
So, what does every rainbow need to form?
Every rainbow needs
raindrops, sunlight, and refraction. Raindrops, sunlight, and refraction. Here comes a rainbow, with colors ablazing. If you wanna see a rainbow, you need three things to make it.
Some like it when the rain stops, but a rainbow needs raindrops, raindrops, raindrops. Watch them fall out from the sky. Next I need something that shines bright, like a beam of sunlight, sunlight, sunlight. One more thing, and here's the action. The raindrops spin the light, and that's called a fraction.
Fraction, fraction.
Refraction? What's refraction?
Well, when the sunlight hits the raindrops, the light bends. That's what makes all of my beautiful colors. See?
Oh, so when the light bends, that makes the rainbow's colors.
Oh, and that's called refraction.
Yeah, you got it, sweet peas. You ready to sing along?
What an incredible honor.
Yeah, we're ready.
Take it away.
All right, sing with us.
Raindrops, sunlight, and refraction. Raindrops, sunlight, and refraction. Here comes a rainbow with colors a-blazin'. If you wanna see a rainbow, you need three things to make it. Some like it when the rain stops, but a rainbow needs...
What's the first thing a rainbow needs?
Raindrops.
Raindrops, right. Raindrops are what rainbows need first.
Raindrops, raindrops, raindrops! Watch them falling from the sky. Next we need something that shines bright like a beam of...
What's the next thing a rainbow needs?
Sunlight!
Oh yeah, sunlight.
Raindrops and sunlight. They're the two things a rainbow needs.
Sunlight, sunlight, sunlight!
Ow!
One more thing, and here's the action. The raindrops bend the light, and that's gold.
All right. So the rainbow needs one more thing to form. What's that thing called when the sunlight bends on the raindrops?
Refraction!
Oh yeah, refraction.
Yeah, that's right.
Refraction, refraction, refraction. Here comes a rainbow with colors a-blazing. If you wanna see a rainbow, you need three things to make it. Raindrops, sunlight, and refraction. Raindrops, sunlight, and refraction.
Wow! So that's how a rainbow is made. That is so cool. Thanks for singing with us. And thanks for showing us how you're made, rainbow.
Thank you! Bye, cuties!
L-A-L-A-L-A-L-A-L-A.
Yeah, that song was pretty good.
Elmo liked it a lot.
Now a clue!
A clue?
Oh, there is a clue. A freezing breeze. I think freezing is a third clue. Looks like Elmo and I get to draw this clue together. I'll go first. To draw freezing, we'll draw some swirly lines, like these. And then some little dots and X's. There, freezing.
Okay, Elmo's turn. So Elmo will draw some swirly lines like these, and then some little dots, and some X's. There, freezing.
Hey, we have all three clues to figure out what kind of weather Spot thinks is coming. We're ready to sit in our...
thinking chair.
Thinking chair, right, come on.
Now that we're in our thinking chair, let's think.
Okay. So we're trying to figure out what kind of weather Spot thinks is coming. And our clues are, a cloud.
A water drop.
And, freezing. So what kind of weather Spot thinks is coming? With a cloud, a drop of water, and freezing.
Well, what kind of weather happens when water falls from a cloud? Rain.
Oh yeah, rain. The drops of water that falls from the clouds is rain.
That's right. But what about this third clue? Freezing.
Well, what if it gets really cold outside? Maybe when it gets cold outside, something else would fall from the cloud.
Maybe. But what kind of weather is that?
Snow.
Snow. It snows. That's right. Because snow is a kind of weather that happens when it's freezing outside. The raindrops turn into snowflakes when it gets cold, and they fall from the clouds, just like rain. We just figured out Spot's clues. We just figured out Spot's clues.
We just figured out Spot's clues.
We just figured out Spot's clues. Because we're really smart. Spot, do you think snow is coming?
Yes, I do. I think snow is coming this way.
Oh boy, snow is coming. I love the snow. Think of all the fun we could do in the snow.
Well, maybe it's snowing right now. Let's go look outside.
Look, it's snowing outside.
Wow! Spot was right. It was gonna snow outside.
Oh boy. That was a good prediction, Spot. How'd you know it was gonna snow?
Lucky guess.
Well, however you knew, that sure was a great guess. It's gonna be so much fun when we go outside to play in the snow. Hey, is there anything you like to do in the snow?
Ooh, I like that too. Ooh, hey, did you guys know that you can play lots of sports in the weather?
Sports?
What kind of sports?
Depends on the weather. If it's a windy day, it's nice to go windsurfing.
Oh look, Dorothy is imagining Elmo windsurfing.
When there's snow, it's great to go skiing.
Wow. Those two are great sports to happen in the weather. Windsurfing and skiing are great sports.
Yeah. Wow, this day has been weather-tastic. Thanks for spending this day with Elmo and his friends.
Yeah. This day has been so great. Well, I think it's time we all went out to play in the snow.
But first, Elmo wants to sing the weather song.